Hello everyone, in this video, we're going to learn how to solve this challenging problem from the Vietnam University Entrance Examination. We need to find all real numbers and show that the equation has exactly two distinct real solutions. So the idea behind this equation is to use the application of differentiation to solve this equation. Alright, so we're gonna let the left hand side be f of x. Alright, so we need to find the derivative of f of x. Alright, so we know that in order to differentiate u to the alpha, it turns out to be alpha u to the alpha minus 1 times u prime. The second one, derivative of this one, it turns out to be u prime over 2 square root of u. So we have f prime of s equals, this one turns out to be 2s power 1 4, right? 2s all together power 1 4. Alright, so it turns out to be 1 4 times 2s power negative 3 4 times 2. Alright, second one, square root of 2s, we apply the second formula right here. It's going to be 2 over 2 square root of 2s. Next one, this guy turns out to be plus 2 times. This guy is going to be 6 minus s power of 1 fourth. So it turns out to be 1 fourth times 6 minus s to the negative 3 fourth times negative 1. Alright, and this one turns out to be 2 times negative 1 over 2 root 6 minus s. Alright, now we're gonna simplify. This guy turns out to be 1 half, right? So this one, I'm gonna bring it to the bottom. And I convert it to radical sign. So it turns out to be 1 half 1 over 4 root of 2s cube. Alright. This one, 2 and 2 cancel out. So it's going to be 1 over root 2s. This one right here is going to be minus 1 and half times 1 over 4 root of 6 minus s to the power of 3. Last one, minus 1 over square root of 6 minus s. Alright, so now I'm gonna combine this guy and this guy. This guy. And then this guy. I factor 1 half out, so it turns out to be 1 and half 1 over 4 root of 2s cube minus 1 over 4 root of 6 minus s cube plus 1 over root 2s minus 1 over root 6 minus x. Alright, now we need to find the critical point. Alright, so basically we're gonna observe this one by observation. We have x equals 2. Alright, x equals 2, make this one 0. This one 0. Alright, so the whole thing should be 0. So f prime of x equals 0 when x equals 2. Alright, now go back over here. We need to find the domain. So the domain of this one. It's gonna be 2x greater than equal to 0. This guy right here. This one, same thing, 2x greater than equal to 0. This is 6 minus x greater than equal to 0. This guy, same thing. Alright, so we need to solve a system of equation right here. So we have x greater than equal to 0 for the first one. The second one, x less than equal to 6. Alright, so the domain should be the interval from 0 to 6. Alright. Alright, so we have the domain of this function right here. It's going to be 0 to 6. And f prime of x equals 0 when x equals 2. Alright. And this guy must be f of x. Alright, so we need to create a table value. Alright, so I have this a s, this a f prime of s, and this is f of s right here. Alright, so the domain is going to be from 0 to 6, so I have 0 right here, I have 6 right here. Now, since the domain of the function f of s is going to be the closed interval from 0 to 6, but the domain of the function of f prime of s is going to be the open interval from 0 to 6, the denominator cannot be equal to 0. Alright, so we cannot take 0 and 6. Alright, so write x 0, f prime of s should be undefined. 6, it should be undefined right here. Okay, now the critical point is going to be 2. Substitute into f prime of s is going to be 0. Alright. Now we substitute s equal to into f of s right here. So we have f of 2 equals 4 root of 4 plus square root of 4 plus 2 4 root of 4 plus 2 square root of 4. 4 root of 4 plus 2 times 4 root of 4 is going to be 3 times 4 root of 4 plus this one. Root 4 is going to be 2. This root 4 is going to be 2. So it's going to be 2 times 2 is going to be 4. 4 plus 2 is going to be 6. Alright, now we need to simplify this one. So it turns out to be 3 times 4 to the 1/4 plus 6. Alright. Now, 4 right here, I just write 2 power of 2. So it could be 3 times 2 power of 2. And all together, power of 1/4. So which means multiply by 1/4 plus 6. So it's going to be 3 times 2 power of 1 half plus 6. So it's going to be 3 root 2 plus 6. Alright, so I have 3 root 2 plus 6 over here when x equals 2. Alright, now I'm going to pick a number right here. So I check the value of f prime of x. Alright, so I pick one right here. And we substitute one into this expression right here. So we have 1/2 times 1/4√3 minus 1/4√5 plus 1/√2 minus 1/√5. All right, now observe that 4√3 less than 4√5. So if we take reciprocal of this one, so it can be 1/1 and then this one we need to flip. Alright, so then this guy subtract this guy must be greater than 0. Alright, so this guy must be greater than 0. Similarly, 1/√2 minus 1/5 greater than 0. So the whole thing right here must be greater than 0 in the interval 0, 2. So it could be positive. This guy positive, this guy is negative. The graph is increasing in this interval and decreasing in this interval. Alright. Now, at x equals 0, we substitute into this equation to find the value of f of x. Okay, so we have f of 0 is going to be 0, 0. This is 2/4√6 plus 2√6. So we put it right here. This will be 2/4√6 plus 2√6. X equals 6, substitute over here. So we have 4√12 plus 2√12. Now we need to simplify this one. So it could be 4√12 plus 2√3. So we put 2√3 plus 4√12 right here. Alright, so the graph looks like this. This is the maximum, okay? So x equals 0 is gonna be right here. X equals 6 is gonna be right here. 0, 6. So in the interval 0, 6, the graph looks like this. Now, y equals m. This is the horizontal line. Okay, so m is going to be parallel to the x-axis. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. Now, in order for this equation has two distinct real solutions, all right? The equation y equals m must intersect f of s as two distinct points. So the lines should be something like this. This is y equals m. This is f of s right here. And it's going to be two distinct solutions right here. So m must be greater than this guy. Alright, so we have the maximum right here. This is maximum. This is 3√2 plus 6. This guy's 2 4 root of 6 plus 2 root 6. This guy. Four root of 12 plus 2 root 3. Alright, so m must be greater than or equal to 2 times 4 root of 6 plus 2 root 6 and less than the maximum right here. Alright, because if I draw y equal m right here, and you see that y equal m still intersect f of s at 2 points, this guy and this guy right here. If m less than this value, so m is going to be right here. We only have one point right here. If m greater than maximum, there is no point, so m is going to be right here. Alright, so it must be between this guy and then this guy. This guy, and then this guy right here. To guarantee that the equation has two distinct real solutions. Alright, so m must be greater than or equal to 2, 4 root of 6 plus 2 root 6 and less than. It cannot be equal the maximum. If it's equal maximum, we only have one solution. So it must be less than this one. Alright, so it's going to be 3 root 2 plus 6. And it's a good time to stop. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Remember that if you're failing to prepare, you're preparing to fail. We rise like tall buildings as the chemicals they take us higher. The night's young and it's just begun as she puts her hand in mine.